أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون صدق الله وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم Distinguished ulama, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, first of all, I would like to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gave me this golden and ample opportunity to come and visit you brothers here in Stockton, and I am very thankful to you that you came here to sit together for a while listening to something from Quran and Sunnah. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we are living in such a time where every single step is taken for a dollar, nothing else. Majority of people, they are thinking of how to get much more. And I'm sorry to say, those who are covered with the rida of deen, with the cover of deen, our approach is not too much different than general public. You are looking for dollars and we are looking for dollars as well. We have to be honest with each other and to be honest to ourselves. Self-deception, that is destroying you here and also in the hereafter. We are making a fun of ourselves, whatever we are doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ حَرْفٍ إِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ انْقَلَبَ عَلَىٰ وَجْهِ خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينُ People, those who are practicing apparently deen, they are not getting in depth as far as deen is concerned. Even though we the Muslim, we are bringing our kids to masjid and we are handing them over to Imam Sahib or to teacher of Quran, that Maulvi Sahib, teach him Quran to recite, but don't take him that much deep in deen, we don't want to lose him. What are you talking about? Do you think you are a Muslim? Do you think you are practicing deen properly? That what Holy Quran says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ حَرْفٍ We are standing on the shore or side. We are not going in depth of deen. إِنَ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اِطْمَعَنَّ بِهِ If you are getting something good of this world in deen, اِطْمَعَنَّ بِهِ You are very much satisfied. وَإِنَ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ انْقَلَبَ عَلَىٰ وَجْهِ But something otherwise, if that happened to you, you turn around, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ Now, خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ This الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ These young Maulvi Sahiban, they said, خَسِرَ What? خَسِرَ The dhamiri mustatar. That is the fa'il of خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ happened as maf'ul and object to this خَسِرَ Means this guy has ruined his life in this world and also in the hereafter. He has destroyed this world and also the hereafter. Otherwise, my dear respected brothers and sisters, we are making dua almost in every prayer. وَيَدْعُوا بَعْدَ صَلَاةِ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ بِالْأَدْعِيَةِ الْمَعْصُورَةِ وَبِدْعَاءِ الْمَعْصُورِ That in the prayer, in the very ending, When we say Salat ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Lama salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ala Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Only to tell you one thing. If you want to clean your heart, cleaning of your heart, say Salat ala Nabi as much as you can. In standing, in sitting, driving. Yes, just make it your habit in your adha. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. My dear respected brothers, you will clean your heart, because the most you are getting close to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are getting close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A visible example, in technology era, in the time of science and technology, when you are too much close to antenna, your signal is working good. If you are going far, then reception is poor. The more you are going far from that antenna, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your signal will become poor. The more you are getting close to that antenna, your signal is very strong. You are getting in touch with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A delegation of Banu Tamim came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they said, oh, the messenger of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we want to be recognized and to be known as the lovers of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, muhibban lillahi azza wa jal, O muhibbin lillahi azza wa jal. So Jibreel Amin came, tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is only one way. In kuntum tuhibbun Allah, fattabi'uni yuhbibkum Allah. In kuntum tuhibbun Allah, if you are truthful in what you are saying, that you are in love with Allah, and you want to be known as lover of Allah, fattabi'uni, there is only one way. Copy me, imitate me. Didn't say, fa'ati'uni, obey me. Obedience, something else. Fattabi'uni, admire me. Fattabi'uni, from the bottom of your heart, be in love with me. So the more you are in love with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are too much close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a big difference between ita'a and ittiba'a. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
No, not like this.
Yes.
Stockton people, most of you, you are hailing from church. And the church people, they have a strength. That strength must be known and seen in your voice as well. You know what I'm saying? A strong man, when we are going to perform his nikah, and when we ask him that so-and-so, the daughter of Mr. So-and-so, the bridal of money of that much dollar, in the presence of these two Muslim witnesses by way of Islamic nikah, have you accepted? If he's a man, he said, yes. Yes. And if he's a weak man, yes. Because he knows that I'm going to quagmire. I'm going to get into dal-dal. Yes? Yes. So there from Qiyas Kunze Gulistani Man Bahar Mara, that what will be happening to this guy? So be strong and say, yes. Yes. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, ita'a, what is ita'a? Whatever Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has ordered and commanded, practice accordingly. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, مَا نَحَيْتُكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ وَمَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِهِ فَاتُوا مِنْهُ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ مَا نَحَيْتُكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ Whatsoever I have forbidden from, فَانْتَهُ, abstain from. There is no loophole. There is no gray area. There is no if and but. Yes. Nothing. Prophet ﷺ said, don't do, so don't go close to. مَا نَحَيْتُكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ There is no gray area in nahi. Yes, in awamir, in commandment, in doings, in practicing, gray area is there because of our weakness. وَمَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِهِ فَاتُوا مِنْهُ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ Try to your best as much as you can. But regarding nahi, yes, abstain from 100%. But awamir, you cannot do it 100%. That's your weakness. And Prophet ﷺ know that. So that's why he said, وَمَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِهِ فَاتُوا مِنْهُ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ As much as you can, but as you know, in such like situation, when Allah says, or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, so dear, you have been tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is looking into your heart that you are doing. Yes, you can make excuses. That much I, to the best of my power, I was able to do. Allah says in such like situation, Wallahu bima ta'maluna basir.
Allah is watching you. He knows what your intention is. In Allah la yanzuru ila suwarikum wala ila ashkarikum wala ki yanzuru ila qulubikum wa niyatikum.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not looking at your dress, at your shape, at your features. Because He knows your feature, He is the creator. He knows your dress that is apparently seen.
وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ وَنِيَاتِكُمْ.
He is looking into your hearts and He is looking at your niya and intentions. And that's why Imam Bukhari, rahmatullahi alayhi, when he started his book, I have written a book on Usul al-Hadith in Arabic. Yes, the one has been printed, Dirayatul Riwaya, Al-Ma'ruf bi Usul al-Hadith. The other one, yes, that is for memorization. I wrote it, but that was a small book for memorization as far as the science of hadith is concerned. So that's why I added to that book another thing. وَالدَّرْسُ الْبُخَارِ فَتْحًا وَخَتْمًا. So there I explained this first hadith of Imam Bukhari and the last hadith of Imam Bukhari. So this hadith, first hadith narrated by Imam Bukhari is إِنَّمَ الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. And Imam Bukhari has narrated that hadith in 7 places under different tarajim ul abwab. In how many places?
7.
In 7 places. There is a little bit difference of words, but mafhum, sense and meaning, that is one and the same. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. And what is niyya? What is intention? You know that we in our body, we have the flesh and we have the bones. Bones is too hard in its very nature. And flesh is?
Soft.
Too soft. Now too soft and too hard, they will never get together. They will get separated very easily. So in between, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put a membrane, a jelly. Yes? A plastic type cover. You know that? Yes? It has both nature. That is too hard and that is too soft. Through its softness, it is getting hold of the flesh from this side and getting hold of the bones from the other side. Niyya is that membrane. Otherwise, your belief, that is something in your heart. Invisible. And actions, that is with by your organs, visibles. Now, visible and invisible thing. Visible and invisible thing, they are not getting together. Please turn off the telephones. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, وَأَن تُرْفَعَ الْأَصْوَاتُ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ. So you can apply the word aswat to any type of sound and voice. Yes, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the sign of Qiyamah, when different type of singing will be happening in masajid. We have different type of tones. And sometime I do make a joke, that as far as our ibadat is concerned, this telephone ringing is second to shaitan. Shaitan is destroying our ibadat and telephone. Yes, and this telephone and modern technology destroyed our ghira, destroyed our families. Yes or not?
Yes.
Say loudly.
Yes.
Be honest with yourself. That is the reality. But you cannot control the technology. It will be going ahead. It will be going ahead. You cannot take away the evils from the world, but you can work on your own self. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, anyhow, now amal, these are seen. Aqeedah, that is, say,
it is
not seen and invisible. Now visible and invisible, how they will get together? So Allah put there in between that type of membrane which is called niyya. So this niyya is holding your amal, yes, past it to your aqeedah. And that's why I told the brothers in dars, that illa allazina amanu wa amilu salihat, amanu wa amilu salihat, amanu wa amilu salihat. How many times that is in Quran? So many times. So I told them that amal is salih, a righteous good deed, that's a protection of your iman. Number one. And from the other side, that is the requirement of your iman. If you are a mu'min, why you are not practicing righteously? And if you are a mu'min, why you are not going to protect your iman with your amal saliha? And I told the brothers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they have taught us such a deen, which is consist of, as far as the practice is concerned, consist of faraiz, wajibat, sunan,
and Mustahabat. I have written a book that is printed now, almost 300 pages, and that is Bidayatul Fuhul ila Ilm al-Usul, of Ilm al-Usul. So in Usul al-Fiqh, I have mentioned there that Sahaba Rizwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, they were not aware of Faraiz, Wajibat, Sunan, and Mustahabat. Their only concern was what the Prophet said and did, and what he did not. Yes, to them, Mustahabat were as important as Faraiz were. Sunan were as important as Faraiz were. They were not making difference in this and that. That is only from academic point of view. That's a case of jurisprudence. So they were studying, what is it? They were studying Talbi?
No.
Usallam Subut?
No.
Was there? Mawlawi al-Husami? Nur al-Anwar?
No.
Usul al-Shashi? Usul al-Hawashi?
Nothing
like that. Yes, Dirayat al-Fuhul of Imam Razi? Nothing like, because they were not aware of. That is for us, that was not for them. For them, the holy soul is thinking what this man is doing and what he is not doing. Yeah, you got the point or not?
Yes.
Say,
yes.
What this man is doing and what he is not doing. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Didn't say, وَلَكُمْ فِي أَقْوَالِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ فِي أَعْمَالِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. What is رَسُولِ اللَّهِ? Mean the entity, means the personality. Look at that personality, that is deen. Idea is supported by the hadith of Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. When Sahaba asked Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, as you know, that the much more aware person of another personality is the wife. She knows a lot about her husband. Yes? And that's why, if outside the house, he is a great man. He's great. Inside the house, the wife knows all his qualities and shortcomings. And that's why she does not believe. Yes? Once I was making a joke that was the wife of Hassan Basri rahmatullah alayhi. Otherwise, never ever a wife will appreciate her husband. Yes? Because she will be saying, oh, when you are going, so your butts are going here and there. Butts of everyone is going here and there. But that is the case that she will never appreciate. But Hassan Basri's wife, when after his death, somebody asked her, she said, to tell you the truth, I have never humiliated my husband in my lifetime. Never said anything to him. Because there was nothing to be said in this regard. And such like appreciation, I think that nobody can do that. As the wife of Hassan Basri did, radiallahu ta'ala an. So anyhow, my dear, neither we are Hassan Basri, nor our wives are the wives of Hassan Basri. So anyhow, you have to face whatever you are facing. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, you are not upset with me. No. We have to be honest with each other. Yes?
Yes.
So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, what I was referring to, that Iman and Amal is Salih. So Iman's requirements are A'mal is Saliha. So as I was mentioning, that Faraiz, Wajibat, Sunan, and the Mustahabbat, these are four circles you have drawn around your Iman. If somebody, he is not taking care of Mustahabbat, so one circle or one wall, protection wall, he demolished it. Now, originally, you had, yes, four covers around your Iman, so Satan may not attack your Iman. One, you demolished. Now you have only three. If somebody is not taking care of Sunan, another wall that is gone. If somebody is too much lazy regarding Wajibat, a third one is gone. And think about a guy who is not taking care of Faraiz. So he has put his treasury all naked and open to Satan. Whenever he wants, he can attack and take it away. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Holy Quran, wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr, illa allazina amanu wa amilu salihat, wa tawasaw bil haqq wa tawasaw bil sabr. You know that before this surah, one surah before this, which one?
Al-Hakum
al-Takasur. The surah following this surah, If you will look into the subject of Al-Hakum Takasur and you will look into the subject of Wailul li kulli humaza, that is dunya and dunya. In between, Allah has put this wal asr innal insana lafi khusr. That where from the khusr comes, from dunya from this side and dunya from that side. From dollar from that side and dollar from that side. So as long as you are not giving the second cabinet or yes, the back cabinet to dunya, you are in khasara. We have put it in front. Even we are putting our deen behind dollars. Yes or not?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alhaakum al-takasur. Hatta zurtum al-makabir. What is alha? Alha yulhi ilha'an. That's from lahu. That is from, and what is lahu? Lobe, kelkud, drama. Al-hakum al-takasur, to make more and more money, to deposit more and more dollars, to make much more property and plazas. Al-hakum al-takasur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, yes, to give you the proper sense of lahu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this has made you dramatic personalities. You are a drama. Al-hakum al-takasur, it has made you lahu. So it means that Allah is not taking you serious as long as you have not put the dunya in the back cabinet. Al-hakum al-takasur. What is takasur? This is tafa'ul. And what is the khususi of tafa'ul, unfortunately? Yes, only Morisim knows. Because in our time, we were studying all these books. Usul Ekbari, we try to memorize. Shafiyah, we try to memorize. That's why these old ulama, they know the khususiyat al-abwab. Yes, and the young, sorry to say, they do not know the khawas al-abwab. That what is the khasi of the bab? So takasur, that is tafa'ul. And tafa'ul has the khususiyat of mufa'ala. And the khususiyat of mufa'ala is amalul janibain. So takasur mean competition with each other to make more and more and more. I am looking at Maulisef. Yes, that he is riding a Mercedes Benz. I am still in a Corolla of 1967. It makes me greedy. Morisev, he is living a house of $1 million. Yes, and I am still in an apartment. That's broken from all around. Cockroaches are running here and there. I am playing the whole night with the mouse and the rats. Yes, it makes me greedy. That's what Allah says, Al-Hakum al-Takasur. This has make you a drama. This has make you a lahu. This takasur and competition. And for how long you are doing that? Hatta zurtumul maqabir. Until the graveyard. Nobody is stopping. Our Shaykh Ramatullahi Alayhi, Mawlana Abdul Hadi Ramatullahi Alayhi. Once I said that, Shaykh, I never heard you in speech, in dars, in normal talk, that you have spoken about dunya or worldly thing, never ever. He said, to tell you one thing. Yes. At that time, we used to have for our ride the tanga. You know tanga? Now, no more. In our village, there are two. Sometime when I want to enjoy the buggy. Yes, the horse cart. Yes, sometime when I want to enjoy, so I give a call to one of them, they bring you a tanga. We want to have a ride. Yes, but sometime back, that was the only ride.
Mercedes Benz.
That was at that time. So anyhow, he said that, look, if you will ride a tanga, it will take you from Shamansur to Ambar. The stop is known. The stop is?
No.
You will come down. If you will take a wagon, at that time buses were not that much known, but what was?
Wagon.
The wagon. If you will take a wagon, the stop is known. You will drop or you will come down there in Jangira. That is the stop. Yes. And he said, there from the buses were going to Peshawar, coming from your area, from Rawalpindi. If you will take a bus from Jangira, so the stop is known, you will come down in Peshawar. And then he said, if you will ride a train from Jangira, so the ultimate stop is known, that is Karachi, you will come down. Yes, and at that time he had gone for Hajj. So he said, if you will take an aeroplane, so the stop is known, that is Jeddah, you will come down. But those who have taken a ride of the motor of this dunya, yeah, he has taken the ride of dunya. He said, nobody knows where the stop is, where I will come down. Nobody is coming down, hatta zurtumul maqabir, until you take him down. He is not coming down. Yeah, you will be taking him down to a trench. So that what Allah says, Alhaakum at-takasur hatta zurtumul maqabir. And then what? What is after that?
Kalla sawfa
ta'lamun. No, no, only just have a stop on that first word. Kalla. What he said?
Kalla.
Kalla. What is this kalla? Yes. Shaykh Abdul Basir is a good word. He's a good man. Yes. And we found out last night that he is a two in one. Shaykh Abdul Basir and Shaykh Ahmad Basir. This is two in one. So anyhow, Allah subhanahu, he told me that my actual name is Ahmad Basir. So both are good. Yes, Ahmad was Basir and you are the Abd of Basir. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alhaakum at-takasur hatta zurtumul maqabir. Kalla. A big no. So Allah says, kalla. That's why this kalla in Holy Quran, mostly that is used for radh. We call it what?
Radh.
Radh, not radh. Yes, radh is not that powerful. But radh almost worked. This is radh. Kalla. So look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you have made yourself drama because of this worldly attachment and accumulating the money and accumulating the wealth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look at me. Look at my body language. Kalla. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nay. Sawfa ta'lamun. Soon you will come to know. You will come back to your sense. And not only that, Allah repeated that. Summa kalla. And then nay. Sawfa ta'lamun. Soon you will come to know. This is not a threat being given by IRS. This is not a threat being given by INS. This is not a threat given by Homeland Security. This is a threat and warning given by the creator of the whole world. When the sheriff will tell you, Baba, you will come to know. So yeah, day and night, you are in trauma. Yeah, I'm not. What will happen? Just make dua. That is only a police. If it goes to a BI, so just think of that. If it goes a little bit further to CIA, this is neither sheriff, nor a BI, not Homeland Security, and nor a CIA. This is who?
Allah.
Allah, the creator of the whole world. So he is giving a threat. Sawfa ta'lamun. Summa kalla sawfa ta'lamun. Soon you will come to know. Now here, in takasur, Allah said so. Go to the surah after al-asr. Wail لِكُلِّ humaza. What is wail?
Alaka.
2 minutes. Number one, hi for humaza. What is wail? Hi for humaza. In English we say, woe to the humaza. And the second meaning, as Maurice had said, halakat. Wail, perished. What?
Perished.
Every humaza and lumaza. Who is humaza and who is lumaza? Hamaz and lamaz. وَلَا تُطِعْ كُلَّ حَلَّافٍ مَهِينٍ
Hamaz.
So what is hamaz and what is lamaz? Al-ayyab, ayanan, wal-ayyab, sirran aw ghibatan. There are two types of people. One is who is biting you in your absence, backbiting. And the one who is making a fun of you in your presence. He is putting you down in your presence. He is saying to you such a thing that is putting you down. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, humaza lumaza, bad habits, bad adat, wail to them. Likulli humazatil lumaza. And who is doing that? A poor guy, he cannot do humaz nor lamaz. Because the moment you will come to know that this poor guy has said something about me in my absence. So, what you are saying? Huh? Yeah. He knows the after effects, so that's why he is not doing that. And in presence, he cannot imagine even to say something about you. That's why Allah says, these practices are done by those who have the money. Allazi jama'a malan wa addada. Because he is not afraid of. Kalla inna al-insan ala yatgha. Kalla inna al-insan. I have memorized the Quran. I know that. But why I am taking a stop and asking you, so the brothers in Stockton may not think that he has brought a new Quran from Los Angeles. This is the same Quran you know. Yes, I am not saying anything from another Quran. That is the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kalla, innal insana la yatgha. He transgressed the boundaries. Humans, they transgress the boundary. When ar-ra'ahu istaghna, the moment he feels that he is self-sufficient. I need none. Who cares? Who says that? Say, someone who has either money or power. So he is a man of who cares. He is a mustaghni. Mustaghni in a sense, he is thinking of himself very high. And just look into the Quran, what happened to the mustakbirin? Who is mustakbir once again? This is istifal. This is what?
Istifal.
In istifal, there is talab and iddia. Khawasul af'al. In istifal, there is talab. Number two,
iddia.
There is iddia. So istikbar means the one who is doing iddia and claim that he is a big shot. And our Shaykh Ramatullahi alayh, he said, Inna Allah la yuhibbu kulla mukhtalin fakhur. And he said, Wala tamshi fil arzi maraha. So I asked him that, Shaykh, in Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes used the word farah, and sometimes he used the word marah. But now when I'm going to explain that in Pashto, so only the Pashtun will enjoy that, and the non-Pashtun, they will not understand what I'm saying. But I don't have any translation for that word. If Fazlur Rahman knows, he will help me out. So anyhow, farah and marah. So I said, Shaykh, what is farah and what is marah? So he said, farah, yes, only for Brother Hussein, I will say in Arabic, that al-farah huwa al-mutakabbiru fil aqwal, wal-marah al-mutakabbiru fil mashi wal-harakat. There is one proud in word.
Booster.
Yes. Not the booster. The booster. Okay. So anyhow, that is farah and there is marah. When he is going, he is thinking that I am holding the heaven up high and I am holding the earth as well, not to split his center. So he is marah in his harakat and mashi. So I asked Shaykh, so he said that farah. He said that is known. I said, no, Shaykh, marah. What is marah? So Shaykh Ramatullahi Alayhi said, in simple Pashto, we can say, wala tamshi fil arzi maraha. Pazmakabane kunawas kunawas magarza. Pazmaka? Kunawas kunawas magarza. Yes. Then you will ask Morisef. Morisef can explain this very well. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَا أَلَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَ يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَ. He will keep him here forever. The wealth will keep him here forever. ہر کے آمد عمارتِ نو ساخ رفت منزل بدی گرے پر وقت. ہر کے آمد عمارتِ نو ساخ رفت وَمَنْزِلْ بَدِي گَرَي پَرْدَخْ. Saadi Baba says that everybody who came here, he made a plaza. Everybody who came here, he made a castle. But what happened? Raft. He went where? The cemetery in between Sacramento, Stockton and Lodi. Yes. A lot of those who have made the castles, where they are? They are at the cemetery. رَفْتُ مَنْزِلْ بَدِي گَرَي پَرْدَخْ. Saadi, he was a great man. Very well-known poet all over the world, yeah, especially in the Eastern world. So one alim, he was studying his book. He said, what a man he is. I should visit him. So he came to Shiraz, asking Sheikh Mansur, Nasir Lala, Sheikh Abdul Basir, Mawli Sahib, Saadi Baba. They were telling him, should take a freeway this and then. At that time, no freeway, but whatever the streets were. He arrived there in a place. There was a hut made of mud. A hut type house made of
mud
and straws. Somebody told him that this is house of Saadi Baba. He was thinking of Saadi Baba that he will be living in a marble house. Yes, in a marble castle. In a marble. Last night in one masjid I was saying that let me give you one thing. That the Sufiya says, that great people, they are living in small houses. And small people, they are living in big houses. Great people, they are living in small houses. Small people, they are living. Why? Because they feel that I am not a great person. How I would be seen to the people? Just make a castle. Whose house is this? Mr. So-and-so. If somebody is there, just put him somewhere in a hut. Everybody will know him. So now that guy, he was thinking of Sadi Baba, that he's a great man, he will be living in a marble castle. Yes, the marbles are there from Italy or something. So when he came, knocked at the door, there from somebody said, who? He said, so and so from such and such area to visit Baba. He said, Baba has gone to Isfahan for a few months. He said, oh, sorry. So he said, okay. So he wrote a verse, a sha'r, that when Baba will come back, just give it to him. What he wrote there, Yasadiya, Sheraziya namat basast. Sadiya, Sheraziya namat basast. Khana addidam basast, kharo khasast. Yasadi Sherazi, your name, everybody knows you. But when I saw your house, mud and straws, and he said that I will be waiting for his answer. Now, his daughter, when she read it, she said, the guest, you will wait for Baba, or I can say also. So he said, you can say also, because you are the daughter of Baba, you are sahibati haq. Yes, not sahibi haq. You are sahibatu haq. Yes, so she wrote, قافلہ رفتن دو ماہم میرا ویم از برائے چند روزائی بسست. That the caravan has gone and we are on the same route. We are passing by for a few days transit period. What is here in this word? This transit period. So this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, من كان يريد العاجلة عجلنا له فيها ما نشاء لمن نريد ثم جعلنا له جهنم يصلاها مذموما مدحورا ومن اراد الاخره وسعى لها سعيها وهو مؤمن فاولئك كان سعيهم مشكورا كلا نمد هؤلاء وهؤلاء من عطاء ربك وما كان عطاء ربك مهزورا انظر كيف فضلنا بعضهم على بعض وللاخره اكبر درجات واكبر تفضيلا. يا سبحان الله, this Quran, every single word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, man kana yurid. His Mauli Sahiban knows that kana, when you put it as a suffix to fele muzare, so it turned fele muzare into mazi istimrari. It turns fele muzare into mazi istimrari or past continuous tense. Man kana yuridul ajila. Whosoever used to. What is mazi istimrari? Used to. Whosoever used to work hard for the good of this world. And continuously. Day and night, he was thinking of the good of this world. Man kana yuridul ajila. And Allah named it as ajila. Ajila mean, yes, swiftly passing. Yes, or a time pass world, or a time pass situation. Man kana yuridul ajila. Ajjalna lahu fiha manasha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we give them soon in this world. Why Allah used the word soon? Because this world is passing very soon. Man kana yuridul ajila, ajjalna lahu fiha manasha. But we give him as much as we will, not as much as he will. Otherwise, me also. Me, I will and I wish to own the whole Stockton. And if possible, so Lord I. And if possibility is there, so Sacramento will be good as well. And if I will own California, still I will not be satisfied with. Imam Tirmidhi narrated a hadith, لَوْ كَانَ لِبْنِ آدَمَ وَادِيَانِ مِنْ زَهَبْ لَيُحِبُّ أَنْ تَكُونَ لَهُ صَالِصًا وَلَا يَمْلَأُ عَيْنِهِ إِلَّا التُّرَابِ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ The hungry eyes of people will never filled up but only with the dust of cover. Prophet ﷺ says, if you will transform and change the sands and the pebbles and the hasba of two water channels, the floody channels. Here they call it, no water is there, there's a river. We call river Los Angeles. For years we don't see in a single drop of water in that river. So anyhow, that is river. So if river full of sand and pebbles transformed into gold and you filled it to its level, not there in depth, to its level, and not only one, but Two, la yuhibbu an takuna lahu salisa. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that human being is that much greedy that he will be looking for a third one. وَلَا يَوْلَوْ عَيْنِهِ إِلَّا الطُّرَابِ. His eyes will never be filled up but only with the dust of qabr. گفت چشمِ خارِ دنیا دار را یا قناعت پر کنا دیا خاکِ گور. Only two things are there. Either the خاک of qabr or قناعت. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us قناعت. Yeah. Never ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me this, this, this. Shaykh rahmatullahi alayh. Once I ask him that, Shaykh, I never heard you that you are making dua for any need of yours. Because we make dua, oh Allah give me a big house, oh Allah subhanahu give me a best car, oh Allah subhanahu give me a big balance, oh Allah subhanahu give me a plaza, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me this and that. So Shaykh Rahmatullah Alayh says, I ask Allah always that oh Allah give me khair. We don't know our own khair. Do you know? Anybody who can give me a surety that this is khair for me. For someone, the poverty is khair. For some other, a little bit money is khair. Yeah, someone, he is looking good. The moment he gets into money, he becomes shaitan. So that is not a khair for him. Inna Allaha la yabtali al-ghaniya fi ghinahu wal-faqira fi faqrihi aw kama qala alayhi salatu wa salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting to test a rich one in his wealth and a poor one in his poverty. So all of us, we are under test. We have a trial by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The poor one in poverty, the rich one in his belongings. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us khair. So I said that, Shaykh, you are not making any dua for any specific thing. He said, I'm making dua for khair only. And I don't know my own khair. Only Allah knows what is khair for me. That's why I told the brothers in dars that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving someone according to his will, not according to his wish. This first his is for Allah, the second his is for the guy concerned. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, everybody wants to be Warren Buffett. Yes, or to be Bill Gates. Or who is the utmost richest person nowadays?
Trump.
Huh?
Jeff Bezos.
No, not Jeff. Yeah, he knows.
Amazon.
Yes, the Amazon guy, yes. Hussein is also counting others' money. He does not have like me anything. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, look at me. If I will ask you that who is the utmost poor guy, nobody knows him. But when I ask that who knows the richest guy, so everybody knows him. Getting satisfied with the money of others. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, don't take me wrong. Don't take me wrong, I am not making a fun of you. I do make a fun of my own self because I am in self-deception. يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَمَا يَخْدَعُونَ إِلَّا أَنفُسَهُمْ. We are in self-deception. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, look at me. Sadi Baba said, کہ گفت چشم خار دنیا دار را یا قناعت پر کو ندیا خاک گور. So Allah says, من کانا یعنی شاء لمن نورید. But as his aim is only the good of this world, he never thought of the akhira, of the hereafter. ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَا لَهُ جَهَنَّمْ يَسْلَاهَا مَذْمُومًا مَدْحُورًا. What is madmum and what is madhur? Madmum is from zam and madhur is from the harayat huru. Yes, like you kick someone from his bed and he fell down on his mouth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that that guy, he would be condemned first. Yeah, to tell you one, yeah, only to make you to understand, even the angels will not be using those words. So how you will condemn someone and humiliating her? Dalla bighirata. The angels are not using these words, but I am only making you understand that whatever the mazamma is, the angels will say to that guy, and then they will hit him. Yes, from back, where the hit goes, you know the place. So, the apple bottom. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, man kana yuridu al-ajila, ajjalna lahu fiha manasha, liman nurid, summa ja'alna lahu jahannam yaslaha, madhmuman, first he would be condemned, madhuran, and then kicked, and on his face. May Allah forgive and forbid. May Allah protect all of us. Woman arada al-akhirah. And the man who were looking for the good in the hereafter, وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةِ وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا. Everybody, yes, word-wise, verbally, everybody. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our akhirah good. Oh brother, how he will make your akhirah good? Yeah, day and night you are working for this dunya and you are making your akhirah good. Woman are, that's why Allah put the condition, وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا. Hal farzul hal is just like shirt. Hal farzul hal, what is it?
It's just like
shart. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةِ وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا. This is the condition. وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا. He has to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the proper way to make our akhirah good. You cannot invent your own way. You will ask Allah. You cannot invent your own way. You will ask Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How you will treat your disease and your sickness? You have to ask whom?
Doctors.
The doctors. Yes, if you will apply your own mind, maybe you will destroy your own kidney. So that's why Allah says, وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةِ وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا. The efforts which Allah said, the efforts which Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has pinpointed. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةِ وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا. And then another condition, وَهُوَ مُؤْمِن. وَهُوَ مُؤْمِن. Because as you know, that evaluation will be taking place based on your iman. If somebody does not have iman, he will be doing a lot of good in this world, but in the hereafter, no effects there. There is no result. وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلْ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْسُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, for someone who does not have belief in Allah and in the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his good and welfare work in this world, that is vanished as far as the case of akhirah is concerned. You are lucky that you said, Ashadu Allah ilaha illallah, wa ashadu anna Muhammad rabdu wa rasulu. You will be doing a little bit good work. Evaluation is there. The scale is there. Allah is evaluating it. And it goes to the same corner of your amal where your good amal has been inscribed by the angels. So, man arada al-akhira, wa sa'alaha sa'yaha wa huwa mu'min, fa'ulaika kana sa'yuhum mashkura. What's the meaning of mashkur?
Appreciate.
Ya jazakallah. Yeah. He comes only once in 2 months for tafsir. فَأُولَيْكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. That their efforts, جَزَاكُمْ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. Because he's doing a lot, sometime he comes once in a month for tafsir. Then he stays there. Sometime he comes, yes, and Sheikh Mansoor, he ran away, I don't know why. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةِ وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. Now look, those who are doing 24/7 for the good of this world, what they do? Eat food. And those who are working a little in 7-Eleven, what they do? They eat food. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُلَّ نُمِدْ هَوْلَ وَهَوْلَ. I ask Shaykh Rahmatullah Alayh, what it means? So Shaykh Rahmatullah Alayh said, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, دَهِمْ دُوْدَائِ خُلِي دَهُمْ دُوْدَائِ خُلِي دِدَّ لَخُتِي وِسْ جُوْرْدَكُلْ. كُلَّ نُمِدْ هَوْلَهِ وَهَوْلَهِ مِنْ عَطَاءِ رَبِّكَ. That we are giving this one to eat and this one to eat. وَمَا كَانَ عَطَاءُ رَبِّكَ مَحْزُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not seize his food even from Fir'aun and Abu Jahl. اے کریمِ کے اس خزانِ غیب قبر ترسا وظیفہ خورداری دوستارا کو جا کنی محروم تو کے بعد دشمنہ نظرداری. But this but a matter of belief. This is a matter of belief. سادی بابا says, اے کریمِ کے اس خزانِ غیب غبر ترسا وظیفہ خورداری. That from your خزانہ, from your treasury, the good and the bad both are eating. Where from the good is eating? From the خزانہ of Allah. Where from the bad is eating? From the خزانہ of Allah. So he said, اے کریمے کے اس خزانے غیب غبر ترسا وظیفہ خورداری دوستانا کو جا کنی محروم. Just test him. Who? Allah. Just put him to test. Make your belief strong in Allah, then you will see how he will feed you. غبرو ترسا وظیفہ خورداری دوستارا کو جا کنی محروم تو کے بعد دشمنہ نظرداری. Yes, you are looking with a merciful eye to your دشمن. So how you will deprive your friend from his needs and necessities. But this is a matter of what?
Faith
and belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, coming back to the ayat which I have recited. And you know that I recited the first few ayat of Surah Baqarah. Jazakallah Mawlisa. Surah Baqarah. And as you know, Surah Baqarah is the longest ever surah The Tawil ever surah of the Holy Quran consists of how many ayat? 286. 286.
286
consists of how many juz?
Two and a half.
Close to 2.5. There is no any other surah of such a length. Is there any?
No.
No. Number one. Number two. This is Madani surah. And a major portion of this surah came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the first and second year after Hijrah. First and second year?
After
Hijrah. Certain ayat are there which came before. And a few of them, the Mufassirin says, even though difference of aqwal, that these are Makkis. But that is not a prophet saying. Attributed to Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiyallahu ta'ala an. The only preferred thing is that Aman Rasul, bima unzile ilayhi min Rabbi wal Muminun, the last two ayat, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received at the night of Miraj. At the night of? And the ulama says that these are the only two ayat Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Jibreel was not in between. Jibreel was not in between Aman Rasul, bima unzile ilayhi min Rabbi. This is a gift he was given where? When you are visiting your beloved, and there he gives you something, that is something else. So Prophet ﷺ, when he was with Allah, he says a specific gift. Two gifts. Number one, the prayer. Number two, Amana Rasul. Bima unzila ilayhim min rabbihi wal mu'minun. Kullun amana billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusuli. La nufarriqu bayna ahadin min rusuli. Wa qalu sami'na wa ata'na ghufranaka rabbana wa ilayka al-masir. La yukallifu Allahu nafsan illa wus'aha. Laha ma kasabat, wa alayha ma iktasabat. When you are visiting a big shot in his office, his authority, and he wants to do you a favor. To do you a favor. But it needs a protocol. It needs a procedure. So he himself tells you that on this paper, just write this application. And then at the moment he signs it, take it. This is your gun. The commissioner. Commissioner is a big shot in Pakistan. You know what I'm saying? Commissioner. It's a big shot controlling a whole big area division, like Rawalpindi division. He wants to you as a friend, you are visiting him. Yes, to do you a favor. Not in our area. When you will cross over Darya Sindh and coming towards your area, Attak. In our area, yes, legally, that is their due right. The government official, they cannot deny to provide them with a license of weapon. Yes, you are Pashtuns. But you have come to the other side. Just cross over the river and come to the other side. Yes, you will have given guns very easily. Yeah. But here, yeah, subhanAllah. When I was in the parliament, so Mawla Ibrahim sir, rahmatullahi alayh, the son of Hadhrat Shaykh Ul Hadith rahmatullahi alayh, he came all the way there. And he said that lot of thieves are there, Qazi sir. And we are in need of gun. So I said, Maulana Sahab, you want to shoot someone or what? He was laughing, but he was hearing very loud.
Yeah.
Yes, he was deaf, so he was hearing very loud. So I said, Maulana Sahab, you want to kill someone? So I said, no, no, only for self-defense we needed. And we went to the commissioner, but he said that we cannot do it because this is Punjab. This what?
Punjab.
This is Punjab. If you would have been in Pakhtunkhwa, at that time, Sarhad. Now, Pakhtunkhwa. If you would have been there, you would have got it very easily because that's a part of their culture. That's a part of their dress. Yes, rifle is a part of their dress. Yes, nobody can deny you to have the turban. You, Mauli Sahib, start turbans. Turban is a dignity. That is a izzah. That is a... Yes? So anyhow, Sheikh Mansour used to have turban as long as he was staying with us.
He's making ihtijaj.
Yes. So he came back, he dropped his turban. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, look at me. So then I said, Mursab, okay, so what he said? He said that if you will get a recommendation from a parliamentarian, so then on his zamanat and surety, we can give you a license. So that's why I came here. I said that, how many lessons you need? So he said, two are okay. I said, okay, I will give you three. Yes. So I gave him three recommendations. He was that much thankful to me for his whole life that Qazi Sahib, he got me three lessons. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Surah Al-Baqarah, La yukallifu Allahu nafsan illa wusaha. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was there with Allah. Yes, Allah intended to do him a favor. Yes, so he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just make this dua, read it. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا وأخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. He told him that just make this dua, write this application. I want to give you lessons. Yeah, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said it and Allah said done and done and done and done and just go back. Yes. How many lessons Allah gave to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم at the night of ascension? ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا وأخطأنا. Allah said, done. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته الذين من قبل. Done. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. Done. واغفر لنا. Done. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. Done. 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 فانصرنا على القوم. Done. تكبير. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam. Anyhow, so the point is that Surah Al-Baqarah. If you will study Surah Al-Baqarah in detail, I was telling the brothers that the brief summary of Surah Al-Baqarah is the aqaid, the ibadat, the akhlaq, the a'mal. The akhlaq, the a'mal. And a'mal includes the state and government affairs as well. Because there are umur intizamiyah. What? Umur intizamiyah. How to run a state, how to run a government. Because when Prophet ﷺ migrated from Mecca to Medina, so he established a state there. That was the first ever Islamic state known by the state of Medina. State of Medina consists of how many miles? From the very beginning, only 276 miles. The whole area was in the control of the Prophet ﷺ, 276 miles. Surrounding tribes, they were not a part of Medina. That's why they were plotting against Rasulullah ﷺ, instigated by the people of Mecca. And that's why Prophet ﷺ was sending there the Saraya. But the Saraya and the expedition. I have written a book that's printed in Pakistan. Our second edition is going out. Yes. And the book is named, that's on Sira. And the book is named, I named it Waqafa Billahi Shahida Muhammadur Rasulullah. That's the name of the book. Waqafa Billahi Shahida Muhammadur Rasulullah. Now I'm teaching them the Sira as a course. And these brothers, when I give them brothers, so I give the papers to them, just type it. So just make dua, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala complete it. It'll be inshallah a good book. But I'm sorry to say, we the Muslims, neither we know the Quran, what it says, nor we know the seerah, what the Prophet ﷺ did, how he was. If you don't know how he was, how you will copy him? You don't know about him, so how you will copy him? How you will imitate him? While your success is depending upon copying and imitating the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in kuntum tuhibbun Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah, as I was telling you once again, that there is a ta'a and there is ittiba'. Ta'a means obedience, that's regarding awamir and nawahi. But ittiba' and imitating, naqal, naqal utarna, copy karna, imitate or emulate, or what? Emulate, emulate is the proper word. Imitate is not the proper word, because there is no. Yeah, imitation, that's not a respectable word.
Imitate is more of a copy.
Yeah.
Emulate is to make somebody an ideal and copy.
Dase. Yes, to admire him. To admire him with aqidat. So that's called emulation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in kuntum tuhibbun Allah, fattabi'uni yuhbibukum Allah. And to tell you one thing else. Here, our kids, the youth, they say, my ideal is Mr. So-and-so. Like a girl will say, my ideal is Angelina Jolie. Yes, or Lady Gaga. Or say, you know them?
No.
I will introduce you to them. Because they are our neighbor, living close by. Now, Sudlata, if you will come, I will introduce you to them. Because they are close by, yes. On our doorstep, there in Beverly Hills. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers, yes, sometimes the student of mine, they take me there. And, yes. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, we have only one role model, and that is Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. What is Uswa? تُسَاوِي نَفْسَكَ بِهِ وَتُشَابِهُهُ وَتُمَاسِلُهُ لِتَكُونَ أُسْوَةً. مولوی صاحب ده تفسیر بیا سر ولیکه. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة تساوي نفسك به ولا تستطيع أن تساويه ولا تستطيع ولكنك تسعى. You are striving وتجاهد, striving hard to be like Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Because if you will make your aim that much high, you will be trying to go. Yeah, two step, three step, four step. If your aim is here, yeah. Just fell down and sleep. No improvement. Muhabbat mujhe un jawanon se hai. Sitaron pe jo dalte hain kamand. Make your target and aim that high and try to climb. Yes. How far you will go? Whatever. But at least that's improvement. You are going ahead. So target Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We will try to be like him. Target Abu Bakr. We will try to be like him. Target Umar, we will try to be like him. You will never. There is no nisba, there is no comparison, but at least you will try. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam. So anyhow, Surah Al-Baqarah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he established the first ever Islamic state, consists of how many miles?
276.
The surrounding tribes, they used to do conspiracies against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The people of Makkah used to instigate them against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That these people who came all the way from Makkah and got established and settled there, they are terrorists. They are what?
Terrorists.
They are terrorists. They will cause you a trouble. Yes. But whenever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to know that such and such tribe, they are plotting. They are plotting to create a problem, to create a scene, to create a masala or a mushkila. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to arrange an expedition or sariya. Expedition or sariya, up 10 people, 15 people, depend, 100 people, 200 people, they just go and have a round up that area. Got it? We call it a flag march. What we call it?
Flag march.
Flag march. When there is any danger, so the police or the rangers, they have a flag march. Yes? They are actually sending a message to the community and to the surrounding area that we are alert. We are
alert.
Hold your horses. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was doing that. If situation was happening, so they were very much ready to fight. But nothing that happened. Very rarely in Saraya it happened. Yes, but whenever they marched the area, they will eat you. Yes. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ya subhanallah, is a strategy. As the people of Medina, Ansar, Rizwanullahi alayhi majma'in. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them. Muhajireen, they did a great job. They left their belongings and their houses and their homeland for the sake of Allah. We left our homeland, Atak and Sawabi, for the sake of Allah, for the sake of dollars. Say, for the sake of dollars. But these Muhajireen, yes, you did. Yes. Okay. So you are born here?
Yes.
That's another problem. So anyhow, my dear respect, now you should make your intention. Even though we came here for dollars, but now you can correct. Yes. Al-ijazatullahika kal-iznissabikh. I have written a book in Arabic, Al-Qawaid al-Fiqhiyya, our legal maxims. Now, the Muftiyani Kiram in Pashtunkhwa, they are studying that book. Yes. So anyhow, there I have mentioned one legal maxim. Al-ijaratul lahika kal-iznis sabiq. This qaida fiqhiyya is only according to Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi, not according to other three imams. And that's why nikahul fuzuli, that is done according to Abu Hanifa, but not according to three imams. Because they don't believe in al-ijaratul lahika kal-iznis sabiq. And we say al-ijaratul lahika kal-iznis sabiq. For example, you are married or not?
Yes, alhamdulillah.
Okay. Who is not married? Mansoor is not married.
Nakir.
Yeah. Okay,
Tariq,
sorry.
Tariq.
No, but anyhow, Tariq is there. So for example, a girl which is not known to me, but I know her only by name. I know her only by name. And I said to Najam and Naqib, come forward. And Tarikjan, come forward. This girl, daughter of Mr. So and So, with the bridal money of such and such amount, in presence of these two Muslim witnesses, you accepted as your wife? Yes? And he said, yes, I accept it as my wife. Got it? Now the three imams said, this is a drama. It does not have any ground. Nikah will never get established. Abu Hanifa said, Rahmatullah, it depends. When the girl will come to know, if she will allow that contract, so nikah al-fuzuli, that is done. Because that is al-ijaratullahika. That is just like as she has made Qazi Sahib as his attorney or agent, yes, before time. Because she approved it. So al-ijaratullahika, kalizmi sabiq. So we the Hanafi, we are in good shape. Now you can make your intention good. That we are here to serve the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just make it. You made it?
Yes.
We are here to serve the cause of Allah and the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How we will do that? You cannot go to non-Muslims and knocking at their door. That we are here. We are there in Los Angeles. We had some time back, we had a guy. Yes, Fahim knows him. Yes. Sometime he was walking, so he got hold of an American. Yes, you know, Prophet Muhammad is the last prophet. Yes, and if you will not believe in his prophethood, you will go to the hellfire. So my friend, this is the time to say, La ilaha illallah. So, got it? So that guy, but he was psycho. Once, they reported to police that he said, he's a non-pagal, so what can we do with? So anyhow, here you cannot do like this. No soliciting. Solicitors are not allowed. That's why you have the sign there on the stores. Solicitors are not allowed. How? Through your practice. Through your actions. Actions speak louder. And look, if I'm doing something wrong back home in Pakistan and Afghanistan, majority of people there, they are Muslims or non-Muslims?
Muslims.
Yes, that is something else. If me as a mullah I'm doing wrong, so they will blame mullahs as a whole. All of them. These mullayan are like this. If Fazlur Rahman is doing that wrong as a tablighi, so the general public will blame the jama'ah. Yes or not? But a common layman, if he is doing, they will not blame even his own family, his own parents, or his own son and daughters. But they will attribute that to that individual that he is doing wrong. Here, as a Muslim, if I am doing anything wrong, a common layman, they will not blame me. They will blame my deen. That's how the Muslims are. Why we are defaming our deen through our wrong actions? So actions speak louder than words. So through your action, yes, once. One white guy, he came there to masjid. I came for prayer, so the brothers told me that this white guy was asking about you. I said, by name? They said, no, the imam. I said, okay. So when I prayed, I said, my friend, come on. He came. Okay. He said, you are the imam? I said, yes, I am the imam. Said, how can I help you? He said, I want to accept Islam. I said, well and good. Welcome. Marhaban bik. Most and most welcome. But I want to ask you a few questions. As I asked the brother yesterday in the masjid, yes, no coercion, no use of force, yes. You are going to accept it with your free consent? Yes, of course, that's something. I asked him, how did you get introduced to Islam? Or how did you know Islam? He said, I'm working with an Egyptian lady. I said, okay. And he said that she's in the mezzanine. I said, okay. If that she is an old lady, so he said, like in between 40 and 50. So then therefrom I said that, sister, you can come down. So she came there. So then I asked the guy that, my friend, tell me how you came to know Islam or something about Islam. He said, I am working with this sister. So I said, okay, you should stop. Now I'll ask, sister, what's going on? So she said, he is working with me in my company. So when that is the time of Zuhr prayer, so I give them time off. So they are going for their lunch, and I'm going to have my lunch and my prayer. Yes, and sometime I do arrange their lunch as well for free, which is not included there in their compensation, but as a favor, because so this guy asked me that I have worked with so many people, I have not seen such like person that he or she is doing this. How you do that? So I told him that because I am Muslim. I am Muslim, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he taught us and he told us to be nice to your co-workers and to those who are your subordinate. Because she said that sometime in Ramadan, I give them some gifts. On Eid days, I give them some gifts. Yes, for free. So he said that, then I asked her that I want to know something about Islam. But she said that I don't know much more about Islam, only a few things I will. And if you want, so I will take you to my masjid. So she said that I brought him for the said purpose. Then I taught him something. I said, look, what a nice lady this is. Through her action, at least she convinced one guy to say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. By doing so, that guy will accept it from the bottom of his heart. If you will force someone, that will not be from the bottom of his heart. The force is gone, he is gone as well. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, anyhow, Surah Al-Baqarah. That is the first ever surah. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a major portion of that he received there in first year and second year. Now, the Sawyat Sahiban, they will say, Sheikh Basim will say, that we heard that Hajj became farz according to Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi, ninth year after Hijrah. According to Imam Shafi, in sixth year after Hijrah. But it does not have any base. I don't know where from Imam Shafi rahmatullahi is our Imam, but he said it. Became farz in ninth year after Hijrah. If that has become farz in sixth year after Hijrah, why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not going for Hajj, or he was not sending anybody to perform Hajj? He sent the first ever delegation of Hujjaji Kiram under the leadership of Abu Bakr Siddiq in what year? In ninth year after Hijrah. But anyhow, Imam Shafi rahmatullahi alayhi says, and maybe he is referring to that this portion of Baqarah wa Atimul Hajj wal Umrah talillah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam received it in sixth year. We say no. He received it in second year after Hijrah. Yes, but that was only how to perform Hajj. When you will perform it, just wait. Is jihad concept is there, but there was no practical jihad in Makkah. Otherwise, Surah Al-Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أُذِنَ لِلَّذِينَ يُقَاتَلُونَ بِأَنَّهُمْ ظُلِمُوا وَأَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ نَصْرِهِمْ لَقَدِيرٌ الَّذِينَ أُخْرِجُوا مِنْ دِيَانِهِمْ بِغَيْرِ حَقٍ إِلَّا أَنْ يَقُولُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ. So there Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given the concept of fight and qital, but that is a Makki surah. And in Makkah there was no fight. Yes, but the basic instructions and orders were there that this is the concept. Later on you will go to lab. Yes, because you study theory. Yes, and then after 5-6 months you are going to lab. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was teaching Sahaba Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam theory. And he said that when the lab time will come, then you will go to lab. So when they migrated to Madina and established the state and the government, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُعْتَدِينَ. Surah Al-Baqarah. Got it? So we do explain it like this. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, so anyhow the ayat, which I have recited. In Surah Al-Fatiha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned three groups. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Majority of Mufassirin, they have given a tafsir to these three groups, that the first one is the Muslim, the second one المغضوب عليهم, they are the Jew, the third one الضالين, they are the Christians. But we, based on our usul tafsir, we are given the interpretation like this, that الذين أنعمت عليهم, they are the مؤمنين مخلصين. غير المغضوب عليهم, they are the كفار مجاهرين. وَلَظَّالِينَ, they are the kuffar munafiqeen. So there are three categories of people. Mukhlis, mu'min, a true believer. Kafir, mujahir, a clear-cut kafir. And number three, kafir, munafiq, who pretends to be a Muslim, but from his heart, he is not a Muslim. So he is called kafir, munafiq. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. So these three categories of people are mentioned there. Also there is a dua. And that dua is ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Guide us Guide us towards Sirat. Oh brother, you are on Sirat-e-Mustaqim, you are praying. You are on Sirat-e-Mustaqim, you are fasting. You are on Sirat-e-Mustaqim, you prayed the Sunnah, now you are praying the Faraz. And still you are asking, no, keep us going on Sirat-e-Mustaqim. Sabbitna ala Sirat-e-Mustaqim. Keep us going on Sirat-e-Mustaqim. Why? The Satan is our Satan and his army. They are sitting, yes, on every step to take you away from the right path. قَالَ لَأَقُوْضَنَّ لَهُمْ سِرَاتَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنَ إِمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْسَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. Satan, he said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered his turning out from the garden where he did not prostrate to Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, so he said that Rabbi anzirni ila yawmi yub'asoon, give me a respite until the day of judgment, until the last day of this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, innaka minal munzareen, you have been given the time. So what he said, laqudanna lahum siratakal mustaqeem. Now you will see, I will be sitting there on the freeway, such a brave enemy, such a brave robber, such a brave thief, that his way of actions, he made it clear, where I will do this wrong, a wrongdoer will never inform the government that I will do it. As long as he knows that the government has the power to control me, or to kill me, or to perish me. But when he will come to know, government cannot do anything. Here the case is not like this, that Shaitan was not knowing that Allah can do anything, because he is Qadir li zatihi. Qudrat is sifat zatiya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes or not?
Yes.
Yes. I've written a book, Ilmul Karam, Tariqhu wa Irtiqaw. Then I wrote a book in Urdu, because I went to Pakistan. So I was visiting the mountainous area of Swat and that area. So there, yeah, subhanAllah, the moment I was starting my lecture and my bayan or my dars, receiving the chit, Hazrat Khuda kaha hai? Chit was saying,
Khuda
kaha hai? So then I said in Pashto, once again the Pashtun will enjoy. Yeah. Where is God? Where is God? Yes, that was the question. So I said that, Tasu Swatiyan Hurir Mujahidan Khalaki. My ma wait to Tasu Ghaban is on Ruizum or President Taraglim to find him. My Hutasu Namurukti. My you people are so last God, yet you have not found him where he is. So they say this is a disputed issue here. Some ulama says that he is sitting on Arsh, and some of them, they are of the view that he is everywhere. You know what I'm saying? So I said that. I said that, oh, the ulama, for God's sake, don't play with the iman of general public. This is an issue of ilmul kalam. Imam Hassan Basri rahmatullahi alayh, he was asked the same question. He was asked the same question. So he said, in sa'altani an zatihi falaysa ka mislihi shay. In sa'altani an zatihi falaysa ka mislihi shay. If you are asking me about his entity, so nothing is like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can I tell you? وَإِن سَأَلْتَ عَن صِفَاتِهِ فَهُوَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الْمَلِكُ الْقُدُّوسُ السَّلَامُ الْمُؤْمِنُ الْمُهَيْمِنُ الْعَزِيزُ الْجَبَّارُ الْمُتَكَبِّرُ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ هُوَ اللَّهُ الْخَالِقُ الْبَارِئُ الْمُصَوِّرُ لَهُ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَهُوَ. وَإِن سَأَلْتَنِي عَن نَسَبِهِ, if you are asking me about his lineage, so he said, Allahu Ahad, Allahu Samad, Lam Yalid, Walam Yulad, Walam Yakullahu Kufwan Ahad. وَإِن سَأَلْتَنِي عَن مَكَانِهِ فَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ. Ya Subhanallah, what a man he was. How beautifully he explained. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ. He is on such a point that he is watching every single atom on this world. He's watching. What is mirsad?
Single atom.
That every single atom and particle he is watching. Yes. And he said, وَإِن سَأَلْتَنِي غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ فَيَكُونُ سُوَالًا عَنْ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَا عَنِ اللَّهِ. If you are asking me something more than that, that will be a question regarding creature, not regarding a creator. Beautiful answer. Say.
Yes.
This beautiful answer or not?
Yes.
So I said that, brothers, so now, I wrote a book in Urdu that's printed there. And day before yesterday, the Maulvi Sahib, he was telling me that All the books are gone. So I'm going to print it once again. I said, just go ahead. Yes. And he said that the learned people, they are buying it, but they say very difficult. I said, the issue is difficult. The issue is difficult. But as they said that, actually the case came from Arabian world. Yes, so now I started working on that in Arabic language. Yes, Hussein, that's for you. And I have written Ain Allah. What is the title of the book?
Ain Allah.
Huna? Am Hunaka? Am Inda Qafaka? This is the title of the book. Ain Allah. Huna? Am Hunaka? Am Inda Qafaka? That he is here, or he is there, or sitting on your neck. So you will find the answer for these questions, inshallah, in that book. Sheikh Mansour, you and Sheikh Abdul Basir both should come there to study Ilmul Kalam once again. You will?
Inshallah.
Yes, that's good, yes. No, Sheikh Abdul Basir is a young man. Yes, sometime in raining. Yes, we have started the class yet. Sheikh, oh, marhaban bika, Sheikh Abdul Basir. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, so there in Surah Al-Fatiha, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Keep us going on sirat al-mustaqim, because we are already say alhamdulillah. But every single step, you are in fear of going astray, taking an exit, because Satan is sitting there, la aqudanna lahum siratak al-mustaqim, summa la atiyannahum min bayni aydihim, wa min khalfihim, wa an aymanihim, wa an shama'ilihim, wa la tajidu aksarahum shakirin. And Ibn Masud says, radiyallahu ta'ala an, khatta lana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam khattan bi'anazatih. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had the spear in his hand. Yes. He drew a line on the ground. And he said, haza sirati mustaqiman. Haza sirati mustaqiman fattabi'uhu. This is the example of sirati mustaqim. Follow it. And then to right and left, he drew a few lines. This, 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 like exits. And he said, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلْ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. If you will take an exit anywhere, it will take you far away from your destination. Because you have taken an exit. So Prophet ﷺ said, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلْ, neither to the right nor to the left, just go straight. فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. So اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ. Where you will find what is صِرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, or where that is. Imam Tirmizi narrated a hadith from Harisi A'war. From whom?
Harisi
A'war. Harisi A'war. One thing else. Harisi A'war is muttaham bil khuruj. That is khariji. He is khariji. But Imam Bukhari, rahmatullahi alayhi, he has narrated from 26 ruwat. 26 narrators. Some of them, they are rawafiz. Some of them, they are mu'tazila. Some of them, they are khawarij. You cannot narrate from a kafir. Can you? Say,
no.
Narration of hadith is allowed from a kafir?
No.
No, but somebody who has a ta'wil, you cannot declare him as a kafir. So yesterday, Abdul Rahman was asking me about some sects. So I said that, look, we in Ilmul Kalam, when we start, so we say, وَبَعْدْ فَإِنَّ فِرَقَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ أَرْبَعَةٌ. That Muslims are four sects originally. Later on, some sects are too many, but originally, four sects. As-Sunnah, wa-Shi'a, wa-Mu'tazila, wa-Khawarij. Ahl-Sunnah, Mu'tazila, Khawarij, and Shi'a. Ahl-Sunnah are Ahl-Sunnah. So now what you can say to other three? Ahl-Bid'ah. What you can say? But you cannot do it their takfir. Yeah, individuals, if he said something, maybe he is claiming that he is Sunni, he is not, he's become a kafir. You know what I'm saying? That is something else. But as far as the basic concept is concerned, you cannot say regarding that concept that this is a concept of kufr. You know what I'm saying? That's a zimni and supplementary issue. But anyhow, coming back, ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Now, how you will find that? What is sirat al-mustaqim? So, sirat al-mustaqim is, as the Prophet ﷺ was asked before, I'm telling you. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, huwa ma ana alayhi wa ashabi. Huwa ma ana alayhi wa ashabi. Sirat-i mustaqim is that path which is mine, known through me. which is of my Sahaba, known through Sahaba. So who are Ahlul Sunnah? Those who are following the practice of the Prophet and the practice of
Sahaba.
Sahaba Rizwanullah alayhim ajma'in. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, in Allah akhtarani, wa akhtara li ashabi faja'alahum ashabi wa ashari wa ja'alahum ka nujum as-sama fa bi ayyihim iqtadaytum ihtadaytum. Rawahu al-Royani. Allama Royani is a great muhaddis. So he said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah has chosen me. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the selected and chosen one or not?
Yes.
Say, وَاخْتَارَ لِي أَصْحَابِي. Abu Bakr came on his own.
No.
Umar came on his own.
No.
Osman came on his own.
Chosen.
Allah brought them to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He has chosen them for the company of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, if we are going to condemn Sahaba, رضوانullahi alayhim ajma'in, we are not condemning Sahaba and not even condemning Rasulullah. We are condemning Allah. That you did wrong. You brought that guy to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is your selection for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Inna Allah akhtarani wa akhtara li ashabi faja'alahum ashabi wa ashari wa hum ka nujum as-sama fa bi ayyihim iqtadaytum ihtadaytum. And Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi, when he was brought to Khalifa Abdul Malik, to who? To Khalifa Abdul Malik. So he said that Imam, so you are against the Nizam and against the system, mean rebellious. He said, not of course. Not of course. I will never disturb the system. So he asked him, so you are supporting the rebellious. He said, what type of support you are talking about? Against the system and against Khalifa? Never ever. I will not do something which is going against Quran and Sunnah. Is going against Quran and Sunnah. He said, you are supporting the children of Imam Ali Zainul Abidin. He said, yes, as far as financial support is concerned, I do that. They are the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he said, but they are against the system. He said that, you know, and though you are cousins, you know, and they, you are Banu Umayyah, they are Banu Hashim. You are cousins. I have nothing to do with your opposition to each other. Yes, I do oppose if you are doing wrong to them. That this is not good. It is not recommended. They are the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered us to be nice to my family members. Got it? He said, so, okay, you talked about such and such issue. He said, yes. He said, it means that you are not following the hadith of the Prophet then. He said, what hadith you are talking about? These Khulafa, Banu Umayyah and Banu Abbas, I have written a big book, Banu Umayyah, Banu Abbas, or Muasir Dini or Siyasi Tahrikat. Banu Umayyah, Banu Abbas, or Muasir. Muasir Dini or Siyasi Tahrikat, where I have discussed the Mu'tazila, the Khawarij, the Murji'a, the Qadariya, and all these sects, how they came into existence. Hazrat Rahman is not giving me a lot of money, like $100,000, to print all these books. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the point is, look at me, that Imam Rahmatullahi Alayhi, he said that if I will give you a brief about my approach, and you can call it my mazhab, so maybe it will make the issues clear. So he asked him, what is that? He said, in kana hunaka shay'un fi kitabillah. If there is anything crystal clear in the book of Allah, without any ta'wil, or without any second meaning or third meaning, fabir rasi wal ayn, from the bottom of our heart. Wa in kana fi sunnati rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If that is in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, without any contradicting riwayah. So it means that that is the only one, and the concept is very much clear. The wording does not have any other meaning. Fabir rasi wal ayn. Fabir rasi wal ayn. Wa in kana an as-sahaba. If that is from sahaba, rizwanullahi alayhi majma'in, wa lahum fihi khilafun. But regarding that issue, the sahaba, they have khilaf and ikhtilaf therein. That one sahabi says one thing, another one says
another thing
based on their ijtihad, because the thing is not that much clear in the text. in the Nusus of Quran and Sunnah. That's why they have different opinion. وَإِنْ كَانَ عَنِ السَّحَابَةِ وَلَهُمْ فِيهِ خِلَافٌ فَنَأْخُذُ بِقَلِّهُ قَوْلِ مَنْ نَشَاهَ. We are not going out of this saying of Sahaba, but that is to us which one we are going to follow according to our own situation. And he said, وَإِنْ كَانَ عَمَّنْ بَعْدَهُ. If the khilaf is from ulama after Sahaba, means the tabi'i, means that so Imam Rahmatullah alayh, he himself met 7 Sahaba. Rizwanullah alayhim ajma'in. One of them was Sayyidina Anas radiyallahu ta'ala. Another one was Amir ibn Tufail al-Dawsi. He is the last one who died from Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Imam rahmatullahi alayh, he met him as well. So he met 7 Sahaba. In 4 ayyamah, he is the only tabi'i imam. The other 3, they are atba'u tabi'i. But Imam rahmatullahi alayh, he is a tabi'i. So he said, wa in kana amman ba'dahu. If that is from people after Sahaba, فَهُمْ رِجَالٌ وَنَحْنُ رِجَالٌ. But he can say that, we cannot. فَهُمْ رِجَالٌ وَنَحْنُ رِجَالٌ. They are men and we are men. Yeah, but I cannot say that they are men. Oh, what a man I am. Yeah, they are men. Hasan Basri was a man. Abdullah ibn Mubarak was a man. Yes, or Sayyid ibn Musayyib was a man. Sayyid ibn Jubair was a man. Imam Rahmatullah alayhi can say because he was a tabi'i. He had all the right, and that is the case. Look at me. They were mujtahideen. They were what? Mujtahideen. This is an issue. I have written a book in this regard that, and I have written chapter. Hal kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yajtahid? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was receiving everything from Allah. He was doing his ijtihad and using his own sense as well. So two opinions. Some ulama say he was not doing ijtihad. He was not doing ijtihad. So we pose a question. Whether he did not have aqal and sense. Aqalul uqala, who was the utmost intellectual person in the creature of Allah? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So intellectual person means he has intellect. He has aqal. So he suspended it or he locked it? He locked it or suspended it? Or he was using that? He was. So when he was using that, for sure he had his opinions. He had his opinion. Later on, I came to a result that why this ikhtilaf is. That majority of ulama, they say he was doing ijtihad. Some of them, they say he was in no need of ijtihad. So I came to the result that those who said he was not doing ijtihad, they are referring to the latest position of the issue concerned. Whenever Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did his ijtihad and said something regarding his ijtihad or based on his ijtihad, either it was approved with wahi or that was changed with wahi. Afallahu anka lima azinta lahum hatta yatabayyana laka allazina sadaqu wa ta'lam al-kazibin. If he was not doing ijtihad, so why he allowed people to stay behind and not to go to Ghazwa-e Tabuk? Allah has not told him that, tell them that you can stay at home. Prophet ﷺ used his own intellect and he allowed some of them not to go to Tabuk. Got it? But that ijtihad of the Prophet ﷺ, that was not approved by Allah. So that's why Allah said, Afallahu anka. In Pashto, he said, Khudai de Ubaqa. What we said? Khudai de Ubaqa ta ulida ili chuti walara. Say, how nice Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, he did not show attitude to Prophet ﷺ. He said, "Hafallahu anka lima zinta lahum." Why you allowed them to stay behind? Hatta yatabayyana laka alladhina sadaqu wa ta'lam al-kazibin. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, look at me. Surah Al-Baqarah. Or Haris-e-Awar. What? Haris-e-Awar. He's muttaham bil-khuruj. We in... Look at me. In Hanafi fiqh, mostly we are referring to 2 great ulama. They are the direct mashayikh of Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim. And they are great muhaddiseen. One is called Shaykh Abdul Razak ibn al-Hammam. And the second one is called Ibn Abi Shayba. And they both have famous books in ilm hadith in a few volumes, Musannaf Abdul Razak. And number 2, Musannaf ibn Abi Shayba. Musannaf Abdul Razak and Musannaf ibn Abi Shayba. And look at me. When we refer to them, so they say, but the hadith is not in Bukhari. So we say that, brother, who told you that all hadith are there in Bukhari? Because if you will drop the tikrar, say Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi, he has only 3,200 hadith. Amen. So that is the total number of hadith. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is 750,000. With mukarrat, 750,000. 3,000. So what about other? These many hundred thousands. So we say, brother, all hadith are not there in Bukhari. In Bukhari there are 3,000 plus hadith. So they say, but Shaykh Abdul Razak and Shaykh Ibn Abi Shayba. So I say, yes, if they are not authentic, so you will drop a big portion of Bukhari and Muslim as well. Because they have taken it from them. They are the direct Mashaykh of Imam Bukhari. Rahmatullahi alayhi. You are showing your enmity to them both because whatever our mazhab is, we are referring to the hadith narrated by Abdul Razak and by Ibn Abi Shayba. So think of that. Yeah. For example, some of them said that taqleed, we are following Quran and Sunnah. Oh brother, what do you think? We are following Potai or Granth? Yeah. We do follow the Hindu book or the Sikh book. You know what I'm saying? So they say that we follow Quran and Sunnah. So we said, brother, you don't follow Quran and Sunnah, you follow Bukhari. You follow what? You follow. They said that because Bukhari is asahul kutub ibada kitabillah. So I said, that's what we say, that you are not following Kitab and Sunnah. Because asahul kutub ibada kitabillah, that is the ayah of Quran or the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This sentence, asahul kutub, ba'da kitabillah, al-jami'u al-sahih li-imam al-Bukhari, this is the ayah of Quran?
No.
Or this is the saying of the Prophet?
No.
Or the saying of Sahaba?
No.
Who said it? The ulama. Who said it? So we say, brother, you are doing taqleed. Your whole mazhab is based on taqleed. Because asahul kutub, ba'da kitabillah, al-jami'u al-sahih li-imam Muhammad ibn Ismail al-Bukhari, we say that as well. Yes, but we are doing taqleed. And you are doing taqleed as well. That's number, and number three. You say taqleed is, some of them, they are going to that extent that making us kafir, that you are kafir. هذا ما وجدنا عليه آبانا. So we say, brother, the ayah is not in your favor, that's not supporting your idea. It supports
our
idea. I've written a book, and that's printed 2-3 edition. Yes, and very famous, alhamdulillah, in ulama and tulaba, al-ijtihad wa taqleed. What? Al-Ijtihad wa Taqleed. This time when you will go to Pakistan, you are American, but anyhow, when you will go to Pakistan, you have to have all these books there from. Because I don't have it, otherwise I would have gone to it. So anyhow, there I have mentioned that Haza ma wajadna alayhi aba'ana. What after that Allah says? Say, awalaw kana aba'uhum la ya'qiluna shay'an وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala condemned the taqleed of those Aba and forefathers who do not have aql nor hidayah. Neither aql is with them nor naql is with them. So ultimately the result is that those who have the aql and naql, both you are bound to follow them. So I say the ayah is the base of our mawqaf. That's not the base of your mawqaf. But brothers, don't play with the iman of Muslims. Muslims are very nice people. The general public, yes. They are listening to us. When we are going to play with their iman like this, they are getting confused. Which one should we follow? Where should we go? And that's what Shaykh Abul Maali, Imam Al Haramain, Allama Jawaini, Rahmatullahi Alayh. He is a well-known mutakallim. And he is an authentic faqih of the fiqh of Imam Shafi, Rahmatullahi Alayh. Shaykh Abul Maali, Allama Jawaini, Imam Al Haramain, Rahmatullahi Alayh. He was doing a lot of debates regarding Ilmul Kalam and these issues of Aqeedah. But when he was in his last moment on his deathbed, the ulama were visiting him. So he said, be my witness. He said to the ulama,
be my witness.
Be my witness. Zayyatu Umri. I have lost my whole life. I ruined it. In these debates. This is useless debate. It did not give me anything. It did not strengthen my iman, nor the iman of others. Rather, it disturbed the people as far as iman and aqeedah is concerned. For be my witness, innama amut ala aqeedat ajaiz أهل نشاپور إنما أموت على عقيدة عجائز أهل نشاپور The common lay bazgaran and farmers, the Bidwan, the Arabis, they have a solid faith in Allah and solid faith in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes or not? Because they do not argue. Their own argument says, Mullahs have said that Allah is only one. Yes, if you will say something else, he will kill you. Yes, Mullahs have said that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last and final prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have you ever seen that any Mullah say, yes, he has sacrificed himself for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Never ever. Yes, from common layman that come because their iman is solid. They said that this sacrifice is accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, so Shaykh Abul Ma'ali rahmatullahi alayh, he said, Ha anaza, amutu ala iman ajayiz wa aqidat ajayiz ahli Nishapur. The old men and women of Nishapur, whatever their aqidah is, be my witness that I am going to die based on that aqidah. And their aqidah is that Allah is only one and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last and final prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As I told you yesterday, that Maulana Yaqub Sahib Nanotvi, rahmatullahi alayh, he was going somewhere on his way. So one atheist or mulhid, came across. He said, Maulana Sahib, said yes. He said, how do you believe that Allah exists or God exists? So Maulana Yaqub Sahib Nanotvi, rahmatullahi alayh, he was a wali of Allah and a great scholar, the founder of Darul Sarfur, founder of Darul Sarfur, Maulana Yaqub Nanotvi Rahmatullahi Alayh. So he said, Quran says like this. Torah says like this regarding Allah. Gospel of Jesus says like this regarding, and Aql says like this. The proof, the evidence that Allah exists and He is the only one. God exists and He is the only one. But that guy, because if somebody is committed to one specific issue, he will be having a lot of arguments regarding that issue. If you will take him away from that issue, he does not know anything, ABC. But regarding that issue, he is a PhD. Yeah? That's why when he is talking, so we the mullahs, we become afraid of it. How we talk to him? We said, there is Fatiha Khalfal Imam, what can we say? Yes. Now I wrote a book, and that's regarding a specific few issues. Al-Ikhtilaf fi Masail al-Ikhtilaf. Al-Ihtilaf fi Masail. Sheikh Abdul Basir is looking at me that how you are writing those many books. Yes, so in Pakistan, I gave a book that is on Khulafa'i Rashideen and Sayyidina Muawiyah and Sayyidina Hassan. That was that much big book. So when I was giving it to Maulvi Sahab to write it down and then to print it, so there was one brother, he's a professor. So he said, Qazi Sahib, you were looking at me. Qazi Sahib, I said, yes. You have written this book with your hands? I said, no, with my foot. And some of them, they asked me, that those many books, how do you write? I said that I don't write. They say, what do? I say, at night, that big bunch of paper, I swallow it early in the morning, the printout is coming from right hand and left hand, and I bring it and give it to them. Brother, if I will ask you that, how do you earn that many dollars? Yes, you know the answer. You are working for that. So I said that this is my only job. I don't do anything else. I don't eat food in. Yesterday I ate a lot. You have that rice, sir, that is finished. That rice was good. Nasrullah gave me a lot and I ate it. So last night, the other brothers there in Brentwood, they have made food. I said, yes, I have eaten that much. That is enough and sufficient. And that's why I did not eat now. There as well, because that yesterday food, that is enough for me for 1 week. Yeah, because I eat like a bull only once, and then I do shwand, jugali. I'm doing what? Jugali. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, now Surah Al-Baqarah. So we said, Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, Haris A'war. I don't forget it. Haris Awar. He came to Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala. Where? In Kufa. Where? In Kufa. In Kufa there is a big masjid. Hussein, have you ever gone to Kufa? I will take you there. Okay. So in Kufa there is a big masjid. That's called Al-Jami'ah. Al-Masjid Al-Jami'ah. So that Al-Masjid Al-Jami'ah has been built by whom? No. Sayyidina Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiyallahu ta'ala an, when he conquered the area in the time of Sayyidina Umar radiyallahu ta'ala an, he was the wali and the general, both qazi, wali and general. As at that time, these sahaba were that great people, that number one, they were the wali, number two, they were the qazi, number three, they were the general. So it means they were not freeloaders like us. Yeah. They were not freeloaders. Whenever sacrifice was needed, they were in the battlefield. Wherever the judgment was needed, they were sitting there as a qazi. Where the administration was needed, they were working as a governor. So Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala an, when he conquered the area, he made two things there. Number one, Darul Walaya, governor house. What? Governor house. Number two, he built up this masjid. Later on, when Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, he transferred the capital, central capital from Madina to Kufa. So Darul Walaya became Darul Khalafa. Darul Walaya became? Because now governor was not there. Who was there? The Khalifa was there. And that masjid that became the masjid of Khalifa. And that is the masjid where Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala got martyred. That's the masjid where Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala got martyred. Yes, if you will go to that masjid. This is the mihrab. Look at me. This is the mihrab. There in the corner is a small door. You will go out, a footpath type thing. You will walk on the footpath where the cars are running. There is a house having four small rooms. You can fix only one single bed and one chair in every room. These four rooms, arch type doors, but doors are not there. That is open. Only the curtains are hanging there. Only the curtains are, that was the house of the Khalifa. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, I entered to every single room there. In one room, there is a well. There is a well. That was a well where from they were drinking the water. And that was the well with the water of that they gave ghusl to Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, to his dead body. So anyhow, therefrom Sayyidina Ali used to come out and come on that footpath, enter through that door and coming here. Allahu Akbar. Yes. In front. Behind your parking, that is Darul Amara. The central offices, the Oval Office, the Pennsylvania Avenue, whatever you can call it. Yeah? That was the Khalifa offices. Yes. Now, no offices are there, or no structure, but only the walls are there, like 3 foot high. But that is made of stones, 4-5 feet wide. Every wall, 4-5 feet wide. I went there. Here is the mihrab. With mihrab, here is a glass cabinet. That glass cabinet, they have saved the place where Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala got martyred. Because here, the guy stabbed him on Musalla. Who was the guy? Abdul Rahman ibn Muljim al-Khariji. So he stabbed him. So Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he fell down there. Sayyidina Ali? Huh? He fell down there. So there on the cabinet they have written, Maqam istishhad al-Imam Ali. The area is controlled by the Shia, majority of them they are Shia. So they have used their own term, Maqam istishhad al-Imam Ali alayhi salam. Yes, so I went close to that. Prayed 2 rakat, oh Allah, this 2 rakat. Give the sawab to Sayyidina Ali, radiallahu ta'ala an. So anyhow, that is the masjid where Ali used to give khutbah and to lead the prayer. Big masjid. And there are rooms all around the masjid. The imam, he was a Shia mujtahid. He was giving me a round of masjid. Yes, so he said, that Hazar Masjid, Huwallazi Banahu, and that was amazing from the mouth of a Shia Mujtahid. Hazar Masjid, Huwallazi Banahu, Sayyidna Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, Zaman Sayyidna Umar ibn Khattab, Raziyallahu Anhumah. So regarding Sayyidna Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, that was not that much amazing. But the way he mentioned Sayyidna Umar, I say, amazing. Hazar Masjid, هو الذي بناه سيدنا سعد بن أبي وقاص زمن سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنهما. And then he said, شيخ, said نعم. تعرف هذا أو هذه هي المدرسة التي درس فيها الإمام جعفر الصادق رحمه الله ودرس فيها إمامنا وإمامكم نعمان بن ثابت الإمام الأعظم. فقلت نعم هذا ما أعرفه لأن الإمام درس على الإمام جعفر بن جعفر الصادق رضي الله تعالى عنه هناك in that madrasa. Then I went from that door. So in the corner there is a big grave. There is a, and do you know the grave of whom? You don't know. Yeah. You are only accumulating money and making deposit and palazas and things. And just spend it. In my lifetime, I never gathered money. Whenever I had money, I used to go from Pakistan. I used to go to Arzul Quran. That let's study. What is the Quran said? The Prophet said this. Yes. So then I went out from that door. So there is the grave of Imam Muslim ibn Aqil, radiyallahu ta'ala an, the first cousin of Sayyidina Hussein ibn Ali, who was sent by Hussein ibn Ali, radiyallahu ta'ala, as his ambassador, and he got killed there. He got killed there. And that was the case that Imam says, now we have to take revenge. Because killing an ambassador, that is against humanity and norms. Ambassador is protected, even the ambassador of the enemy is protected. They have cheated us. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Haris-e-Awar, Sabiq said. Who?
Haris-e-Awar,
radiallahu anhu. He said, marartu bi unasin fil masjid. People, they have halaqat here in masjid. A few of them here, a few of them. Yakhuzuna fil hadith. They were talking about worldly things in masjid. Yeah. How the business is working, that property, what you did, yes, your car is working good or not, and how is your dealership, and so Haris-e-Awar, he said, when I saw the people talking like this, so Imam Ali was sitting there, said, came here, Amirul Islam alayk, wa alaykum as-salam. He said, inna nas, yatahaddasuna fil masjid, bi ahadith al-dunya, that masjid is basically for ilm and ibadah. And they have made it a place to talk about their worldly businesses. So he said that Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he asked me, Awa qad fa'al? Are you sure? It means that at that time they were not imagining like that, that people will be talking about worldly attachment. If they are here, some spirituality. So he said, Awa qad fa'al? Are you sure? They have done it. Qultu na'am. I said, yes. So what Sayyidina Ali said? قَالَ أَمَّا أَنِّي فَقَدْ سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. I heard the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he told us, إِنَّهَ سَتَكُونُ فِتْنَة. Soon there will be a great fitna, a big fitna. Our fitna is my jinns in the meaning of jama. إِنَّهَ سَتَكُونُ فِتَنٌ كَسِيرَةٌ. Second meaning of hadith is سَتَكُونُ Fitanun kasir. There will be lot of fitna, innumerable, uncountable, lot of fitnas. Qulna fumal makhraj minha ya Rasulallah. Sayyidina Ali said, we said, oh, the messenger of Allah, what's the way out? What? Mal makhraj minha, exit. You have the exit? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive and forbid. If something happening here, you will go out there from. That's why you arrange what? The exit. So we said, what is the exit? If fitna are there, how we will go out of that fitna? قُلْنَا فَوَ الْمَخْرَجُ مِنْهَا قَالَ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, what is the exit?
كِتَابُ
اللَّهِ, the book of Allah. فِيهَا أَوْ فِيهِ سُنَنُ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ. In that holy book, there are the stories of ummas before you. There are stories of success and stories of khusran. Stories of success and stories of khusran and loss, that those people, they got ruined. Those people, they got successful. And that is history. History itself is not a purpose to relate it. You have to pick up the bottom line. Not to do what the ruined people did. And you have to do what the successful have done. inna satakunu fitna qulna fahumul makhraju minha qala kitabullah fi sunan man kana qablakum wa khabaru ma ba'dakum. What will be happening in future? You are going to die. What will be there in the grave? I have written a book. Qabar ki dunya, khabar ki dunya. Once again, the Rahman is looking at me, that this book, I will print it. Qabar ki dunya, khabar ki dunya. So anyhow, that the world of qabar is the world of khabar, that's not the world of nazar. If you will open the qabar, you will not see anything therein. Because that's a matter of different words. So that is khabar ki dunya. What the Prophet said, you must believe in that. If you will not, you will lose your iman. You do not believe in the Prophet ﷺ in the proper way. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, فِيهِ سُنُونُ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ وَخَوْرَ مَا بَعْدَكُمْ وَحُكْمُ بَيْنِكُمْ. Whatever disputes or conflicts you have, the judgment is there in the holy book. The hukum is there. Say, in the holy book. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَهُوَ الَّذِي لَا تَزِيغُ بِهِ الْأَهْوَى وَلَا يَشْبَعُ مِنْهُ الْعُلَمَى وَلَا يَخْلَقُ بِكَسْرَةِ الرَّدْ. That this is a book, لَا تَزِيغُ بِهِ الْأَهْوَى. People will be wishing and willing other way around to destroy this book and to pervert it and to bring changes to. In the past 1500 years, how many people tried to change the concept of Quran? They became successful? They have changed a comma or colon or semicolon of the book?
No.
Why? Inna nahnu nazzalna zikra wa inna lahu lahafizun. Prophet said, "Who is the one? La tazighu bil ahwa." The ahwa of people will not be able to do it, to bring any crookedness to this book. Wa la yashba'u minhu al-ulama. And that's such a book. If you will read a book once, twice, thrice, yes, let it go to the trash. Holy book is the only book. Somebody who is in love with that book, he will be having it 24/7. 24/7. The ulama, they are not becoming fed up with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, as a lover is not becoming fed up with his beloved. Is there any concept of fedding up with, say,
no,
with beloved? No. وَلَا يَشْبَعُ مِنْهُ الْعُلَمَاءَ وَلَا يَخْلَقُ بِكَسْرَةِ الرَّدِ. How many times you have listened to the qira'ah of Nabil or qira'ah of Brother Basim or qira'ah of Samir or qira'ah of Sabiq Sib or qira'ah of Mawlvi Sib? Have you got fed up that this ruku or this part of Quran we heard 10 times, just recite something else? Have you ever heard anybody?
No.
Who has ever said like this?
No.
Yes, once again, yes, that recitation. Yes, then you are driving to San Francisco. Oh, that recitation. This is the ijaz of Quran. وَلَا يَخْلَقُ بِكَسْرَةِ الرَّدِ. وَلَا يَخْلَقُ خَلِقَ يَخْلَقُ بِمَعْنَى becoming old, rotten. وَلَا يَخْلَقُ بِكَسْرَةِ الرَّدِ. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَهُوَ الَّذِي إِذَا سَمِعَتْهُ الْجِنُّ فَقَالُوا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا قُرَانًا عَجَبًا يَهْدِي إِلَى الرُّشْدِ فَآمَنَّا بِهِ. That this is the book. When the jinnat and the demon heard it, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going to what? Because there are two stories. One is mentioned there in Al-Ahqaf, the second one in Al-Jinn. Mostly the Mufassirin said both are one and same story. وَاِسْتَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرَ مِنَ الْجِنِ. And number two, قُلْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ أَنَّا وَاسْتَمَعَ نَفَرَ مِنَ الْجِنِ. We don't agree. I have written in my Arabic tafsir that, in Urdu tafsir that, in English tafsir that, in Pashto tafsir that. That these are two different, stories. Different stories. The first one in Ahqaf, that was when Prophet ﷺ was coming back from Taif and he was staying in An-Nakhla. He was staying there? And where is An-Nakhla? If you are going for Hajj or Umrah through Jordanian airline, through what?
Jordanian
airline. So the Miqat is coming there. Now that is not called An-Nakhla. They call it Qarn al-Sa'alib or Qarn al-Manazil. Qarn al-Sa'alib? So that Qarn al-Sa'alib or Qarn al-Manazil, at that time it was called An-Nakhla, because a lot of gardens and dates are there. And that was Shaykh al-Hadith Sanatullah Alayh, as long as he was alive and he was there in Medina. Who? Mawlana Zakariya Sanatullah Alayh. So he used in summer to go there for a few days and night and staying there in the same garden where Prophet ﷺ stayed when he was coming back from Taif. And until his life, now no more, but until that time, the same grape tree was alive where the Prophet ﷺ ate. Got it? The Utba and the Rabi'a garden, because Prophet ﷺ, he got hit by the people of Taif with stones and his body was bleeding and he was only one companion. Who was that? Say. Zayd ibn Haritha, radiyallahu ta'ala. Yes, and he was trying to protect the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When tens of teenagers, they were hitting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Zayd ibn Haritha, subhanallah, rahimahullah, wa radiyallahu anhu. He said that I was trying to hold the stone so it may not hit the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. From head to toe, I got injured. But still, that was such a storm of stones that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was bleeding as well. So he says, for 3 miles they were doing that. Not for 10 yards, 20 yards, for how much? From 3 miles. And he said, they were hitting the Prophet ﷺ on his legs. He was bleeding. Because of bleeding, sometimes Prophet ﷺ used to sit on the ground. So these teenagers, they used to hold him and to make him stand and walk. And then they start. So he says that when we arrived in that place, and the teenager left us alone. So then the Prophet ﷺ told me that, Zayd, we have to stay here for a few days and nights to get healed. Then we will go ahead. I said, Ya Rasulullah, where we will go? We have left Mecca forever. So Prophet ﷺ told us, we'll go to Mecca because that's our birthplace. That's our original homeland. If somebody is deported, so where they send them? Homeland. To homeland. So as they have not given a shelter, so we have to go back. Anyhow, he was staying there, that is Nakhla. That was one incident. The second one, when Prophet ﷺ was going to Uqaz. Uqaz was an annual swap meet. You call it guard. You call it what?
Guard flea market.
Guard flea market. So that was a flea market, but annual flea market. People from all around Arabia, they used to bring their stuff and to sell it there, and it was going on for 1 month or more than that. And at that time, they were not showing any enmity to one another, even though they have killed one another, but that was in Ashur al-Haram, so they were not fighting. The writers, the poets, the dramas, and the actors, and whatever at that time the entertainment was, they were doing that in the bazaar. Yes, that was like Six Flags or something like that as well. Six Flags or Disneyland. That was their Disneyland. People were coming. Prophet ﷺ was also going there. But he was not going for entertainment. He was going there to convey the message. And that one Yemeni Sahabi, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he says that I was there in the bazaar of Uqaz. So I saw one man that he was walking in bazaar here, there, and there, to there, and he was saying, Ya ayyuhan nas, qulu la ilaha illallah tuflihu. An old man was behind him and he was saying, La tusaddiqu fa innahu kazzab, is majnoon. He is an insane person, don't listen to him. So he said that I saw this scene for the first time. I came close to one guy. I said, what's going on? You know, this is some acting or what? He said, no, this is not acting, this is a real story. He said, what is the story? He said that this man, he claims to be the messenger of Allah. His name is Muhammad. He is from Mecca. His name is Muhammad. He is from Makkah. I said, the old man behind him, white bearded. He said, that's his real uncle, Abu Lahab. Abdul Uzza. That's his real uncle. He is after him. So I asked him that, what do you think? He said, the old man is wrong. He said, the old man is wrong. So I said, you should say it. He said, I cannot. The people will kill me. So I said, but I'm going to this man and I'm accepting his message. Because when you say that he's right, so we should accept it. Then why we are waiting for? So anyhow, Prophet ﷺ was going to Uqaz. Ibn Abbas says, Ma'a nafarin min sahaba. With a few sahaba, rizwanullahi alayhi majma'in. So once again, when he was going to Uqaz, Uqaz is in between Taif and Makkah. So once again, he was staying there in An-Nakhla. Because of that confusion, the Mufassirin said that that is one story. We say, no, that's a different story. Yes, the first one, Ahqaf, when he was coming back. The second one, Surah Jin, when he was going to Uqaz. وَهُوَ الَّذِي إِذَا سَمِعَتْهُ الْجِنِ فَقَالُوا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا قُرْآنًا عَجَبًا. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وَهُوَ الزِّكْرُ الْحَكِيمُ. وَهُوَ الزِّكْرُ الْحَكِيمُ. That is الزِّكْرُ الْمُحْكَمُ. Hakim is in the main meaning of muhkam. And ta'id is kitabun uhkimat ayat. Kitabun uhkimat ayat. Nobody can bring any change to a single word of Holy Quran. To a single ayah of Holy Quran, when kuntum fi raybin ma nazzalna ala abdina fatu
bisurati min
wad'u shuhada'akum wa ulama'akum min dunillah in kuntum sadiqeen. You are mahara, you are mahirin, you are shuhara, you are writers, you are danishwar, you are wise men. Just call them, all of them. Wad'u shuhada'akum, to compete this Quran only with one single surah like Suratul Asr or Suratul Kawthar. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, وَهُوَ الزِّكْرُ الْحَكِيمُ. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَهُوَ الصِّرَاطُ الْمُسْتَقِيمُ. This Quran is the straight path. So when we say, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمُ, it means that give us tawfiq to follow the Quran in word and spirit. In word and spirit. And now, coming to the ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Alif, Lam, Meem. What's the title for these letters? Muqatta'at. What? Muqatta'at. The title is?
Muqatta'at.
Ayat of Holy Quran are of three types in this regard. Muhkamat, Mutashabihat. And number three? Muqatta'at. As far as Muhkamat is concerned, a literate Arab, not Arab, a literate Arab who knows the literary language, for him, those ayat are very easy to understand. Because that's his language. Literary language, and he's a literate person. Mutashabihat. The literary Arab, or the literate Arab, he can know the word meaning, or the literal meaning, but he does not know the sense. He does not know? Say.
The sense.
The sense. Hunna ayatun muhkamatun wa ukharu. Mutashabihat. So for mutashabihat, you are bound to go to a proper alim of Quran and Sunnah, that what this ayah mean. Ar-Rahmanu ala al-Arsh istawa. What this ayah mean? Yadullahi fawqa aydihim. What this hadith mean? Yanzil rabbukum kulla laylatin ila ila samai dunya. These are called mutashabihat. So the literal meaning is known to everybody, but the proper sense is known only to the proper scholar, rasikhun, wa rasikhuna fil ilm. To rasikhin. And as far as the case of muqatta'at is concerned, the meant meaning. What?
Meant.
The meant meaning is not known neither to ulama nor to literal Arab or literate Arab. To nobody. That's why Morishev said, Allahu alamu bi muradihi bi zalik. But as far as the case of ta'wil or secondary meaning, that maybe. Or maybe. What is ta'wil?
Maybe.
So this maybe, the ulama has started it even since the days of Sahaba Rizwanullahi alayhi majma'in. Mostly, that is from Ibn Abbas, Ibn Masud, radiyallahu anhuma, Ubayy ibn Ka'ab, Usman ibn Affan, Sa'id ibn Zayd, Rizwanullahi alayhi majma'in, and later on the Tabi'in. Rahmat. So our Shaykh al-Shaykh, Mawlana Hussain Ali Sahib, rahmatullahi alayhi. He said, Alif, Lam, Meem. Alif, Awwal. Lam lazim, mim mu'min. Al awwal al lazim lil mu'min is zalik al kitab. So he said that alif lam mim is mubtada and zalik al kitab isme ishara and musharun le, both combination of isme ishara and musharun le, both, that is the khabar of alif lam mim. So how you will explain it? Alif awwal, alif
awwal,
lam
lazim,
mim mu'min, al awwal al lazim lil. The first ever mandatory thing for a mu'min is Zalik al-Kitab, this book. الأول اللازم للمؤمن ذلك الكتاب. And then another meaning that Alif Lam Mim El Maulis have said Allah Anab Umradi, don't spare it. Just put it aside. Alif Lam Mim, we believe in that. That's a part of Quran. And that's Quran. Got it? Say.
Yes.
Got it or not it?
Yes.
Yes. Now we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. So where you be looking for Sirat al-Mustaqim? Guide us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered right away. Zalik al-Kitab. You are looking for Sirat al-Mustaqim?
Zalik al-Kitab.
This is the book. This is Sirat al-Mustaqim. La rayba fihi. There is no doubt therein. Yes. Wa kam min murtabin fihi. People are there who have a doubt in this Quran. But as far as Quran itself is concerned, there is no room for doubt. Is there any? Zalik al-Kitab. La rayba fihi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say la murtaba fihi. Lot of murtabin are there.
La
rayba fihi. There is no doubt therein. Hudal lil muttaqin. A perfect guidance. For God fearing people. What else? Once I was there in a test. Exam. 3 hour exam. I was writing my paper. So, he was our Sheikh, Dr. Shafuddin Khattab. He was teaching us science of Hadith in International University. So, from Egypt. He was a big alim. So, at that time, when the time was over, 3 hours, so he was collecting the answer papers. So I said, Fadilat al-Doktor, yes. Baqiya hissa, baqiya hissa min al-jawab. If you can give him a little bit more time, yes, a little bit portion, still remain, I have to write it. So he said one sentence and it was very good. I quoted. He said, Fadilat al-Qazi. I said, Naam Doktor. He said, العمر قصير والعلم كثير. العمر قصير والعلم كثير. That knowledge is a lot. The life is too short. Yes, whatever you have written, that is more than enough. So العلم كثير والعمر قصير. قصير. So that much is enough. Furthermore, الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى أصحابه أجمعين اللهم ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمشايخنا والتلاميذنا من له حق علينا ومن له حق عليه ولإحبابنا ولأقربائنا والجميع وأوصانا بالدعاء اللهم استر عوراتنا ومن روعاتنا واشفع آهاتنا واقض حاجاتنا وأدنا كل معين زهيرا ربنا عنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك ربنا احسن عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها وجدنا من الدنيا وصعب الآخرة لا إله إلا الله الحليم الكريم سبحان الله رب العرش العظيم الحمد لله رب العالمين نسألكم موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والغنيمة من كل بر والسلامة من كل إثم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة لك إلا قضيتها ولا دينا إلا أديتها ولا مريضا ومرضا إلا شفيت ولا ميت المسلم إلا غفرت له ولا مشكلة إلا سهلت ولا طالب علم إلا علمت ولا عالما إلا عملت ولا عامل إلا أخلصت ولا مخلص إلا قبلت ولا مجاهدا إلا نصرت ولا عدوا إلا هزمته وكبدته والله سبحانه وتعالى these are very nice people. The Muslims are very nice people. All of us, we are the followers of your beloved Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. والله سبحانه وتعالى we were sitting here for your good pleasure, be pleased with us. Whatever we said, it's right, please accept it. If accidentally something wrong came out of our mouth, Allah forgive us. Allah forgive us. These brothers and sisters, they listened to us very carefully and very attentively. They were focusing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them a lot of khair here and also in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our ulama the proper representative of Quran and Sunnah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our general public and Muslims the proper followers of ulama in the right and true sense. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help out the Muslims all over the world from the atrocities and zulm and wrongdoing they are facing. Because a lot of brutality and cruelty is going on all over the Muslim world. But we are the followers of Muhammad. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the last and final prophet of Allah to the whole world, to humanity in general. So we have to think about humans in general. Allah bring khair to this whole world. Allah bring khair to this whole world. Allah subhanahu. When we say bring khair to this whole world, so we are asking that for non-Muslims as well. That Allah bring khair. And the big khair for non-Muslim is guide them to the right path. Guide them to the right path. Guide them to the right path. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khair khalqi Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi.